All right. I'm trying to speak up. Okay, back to John. We left off in Gospel of John, verse 12. Was where we left off. Now we're in 13. Which were born, which is the word begotten in Greek, not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of Yahweh. This word born, I could speak for a week on. Which is actually who were born, according to Irenaeus, Tertullian, Augustine, who was begotten, the hus, who, agreeing with Otto, Anamo Otto in Greek. It was the incarnation of him who was not begotten by human generation. The Latin Codex Veronicus before Jerome's Vulgate reads, Quae natus est. Tertullian in De Carne Christi says that believers could not be intended in this verse, since all who believe are born of blood. He ascribes the reading of this received text to the artifice of Venetian. Gnostics of the 2nd and 3rd century. Let's see, the English Encyclopedia Britannica, 11th Cambridge edition, for more on this. Born is begotten, as in Matthew 1, verse 2. We'll go to that now. Matthew 1, verse 2 reads, Abraham begot Isaac. Isaac begot Jacob. Jacob begot. Okay. To the word begot, it is actually in Greek, it is geneo. When it is used of the father, it means to beget or engender. When it is used of a mother, it means to bring forth into the world. But has not the intermediate sense. And when used, and it has not the intermediate sense to conceive. Is a begotten to okay, it is also begotten. So geneo means to begin, like Genesis means to bring to birth. That's where the word geneo in Greek comes from, which is the word begotten, which is actually what is represented here in the King James by the word born. We'll also look more deeper into this word begotten, because it's worth, it's just worthy of looking at. Okay. Begotten is as the only begotten Son. That's why it's so important. He was not born, he was begotten. It thus appears without the shadow of a doubt that the day assigned to the birth of Yeshua, December 25th, was the day on which he was begotten of the Holy Spirit, Pneuma Hadion in Greek, divine power. And his birth took place on the 15th of Ethany, September 29th, in the year following, thus making beautifully clear the meaning of John 1, verse 14, which we have yet to come to. The Word became flesh, as in Matthew 1, 18 and 20. On the first of Tebeth, or December 25th, 5 B.C., and tabernacled, the word tabernacled, eskeneosen, with us, in Greek, eskeneosen, on the 15th of Ethanim, or September 29th, 4 B.C. The 15th of Ethanim, or Tishrei, the month of Tishrei in Hebrew, was the first day of the Feast of Tabernacles. So he tabernacled amongst us. The circumcision, therefore, took place on the 8th day of the feast, the 22nd of Ethanim, October 6th and 7th, a lot of our years. So that these two momentous events fall into the proper place and order, and the real reason is made clear why December 25th is associated with Yeshua and was set apart by the Apostolic Church to commemorate the stupendous event of the Word becoming flesh. And not, as we have so long been led to suppose, the commemoration of a pagan festival. Okay, there's also the festival of Michael and the angels, which is on the 29th day of September, which is reason that day is of particular interest. But the church has lost sight of its reason. The begetting, Genesis, of the day of Yeshua was announced by the angel Gabriel. The birthday of Yeshua is unnamed in either